지금의 믿음.
This is Alex.
Hey, how are you doing?
I mean, the guys in the office are safe again, lunch. Shots?
Who's that you were chatting to?
Vish? Mm. Oh, he's a real laugh, actually. You two really get on. Oh, that's so annoying. My mates from back home, they're down next week. I never get to see them. They want to take me out for this birthday thing. But I can't miss any more work, though. I've already got a final warning from last week for being late last week.
Why don't you use me? Say, dunno, I've got a funeral. I need you there.
Somebody's gonna ask me, are they?
It's been brought to my attention that you weren't at any funeral on Thursday.
Am I fired? What am I supposed to do?
You know my landlord's putting the rent up.
Yeah. I know it's proper early days, and this might seem a bit mental, but...
I can't afford to rent here.
No, I know. But, just pay me when you can.
I've had 3 rejection emails today. I actually don't think anyone's gonna give me a job.
Hey. Listen, don't take this the wrong way. You know I love how you dress, it's just... So maybe this whole job thing is just down to first impressions.
That's exactly what I'm talking about.
You just, you deserve something classier.
So basically I dress like a slut?
Never said that, did I?
You know, you're actually being quite rude and I love this top, so.
Why even ask for my opinion? I'm trying to help you get a job, bring some money in. Christ, wasting my time.
Hello, stranger. Where have you been hiding? I feel like I've not seen you in ages.
Wednesday offered me your old job.
And someone had to get it.
So is that why you've been ghosting me then?
Not texting me back.
What are you on about?
I haven't got any texts.
Hey.
Where the hell have you been? I left you like 6 messages. Look at the mess I've had to sort.
Sorry, I just went to see my old work lot.
Well, I suppose Fish was there.
Babe.
You knew it! Seriously! The clothes you wear, the food you eat, and this is what I get after everything I've done for you. See what you made me do? Covered in your slut makeup.
Sorry. Work has me so stressed lately. They're not paying me the same commission. I'm gonna need you to start contributing somehow. If we don't start getting some cash in soon, I'll have to start making some cutbacks. So when is it, this interview?
Tomorrow morning. Pretty early.
We should celebrate. It's a big thing. Hey!
There we go.
Oh, I'm okay, thank you.
What? This is expensive stuff. Wait to finish it.
Okay, so who thinks that Alex has committed a criminal offence against Rachel?
For me, it boils down to what you consider abuse. I consider that emotional abuse, but I don't think there is sufficient evidence for it to be considered a crime.
He clearly knew what he was doing, encouraging her to drink the night before a job interview, and I think that that was a deliberate act of sabotage.
What do you think, Emily?
I don't think you would classify it as a criminal conviction, but I think it should be.
The offence is controlling or coercive behaviour in an intimate or family relationship. When it has got to that level, that it has affected somebody else to the point where it's had an effect on their day-to-day activities, that's when we know it's turned into a criminal offence.
So moving her in, was that coercive control?
In itself, not necessarily, but taken as part of the overall pattern, yes.
Controlling her finances?
Yes.
It's covered in your slut makeup.
Calling her names?
Yes, part of the pattern of behaviour.
Isolating her from her friends?
Definitely.
Is there anything else that you need to prove coercive control?
So you have to either prove that there have been at least 2 occasions where somebody has caused you to fear violence could be used against you, not necessarily in that incident, at any time.
Have we seen 2 in the drama?
I think we've definitely seen 1, and that was where the plate was smashed.
I didn't actually know that there was the crime of coercive control and people are actually being given jail sentences for it. It is an eye-opener.